time you sober to really speak to somebody that is not under the influence of alcohol or any abusive substance. So we say that the person is in a conscious state of mind.
That's right.
If you are to look into the Bible is really speaking to being calm and collected, being in a state of mind where you can reason careful. So the Bible said, be careful when you are in the last days.
Yes.
Then he was warning Timothy that perilous time shall come. And I would like to put it in today's context that perilous time is here.
That's right.
If a woman can take a child that came from out of her womb and threw it into a pit, we know that something is wrong. If we can look at today's day, we are personally being so perverse here that don't know the difference between gender, we are in a serious situation.
Yes.
If we are in a situation where the government of today's day is not going to have the people's best interests at heart, we know that we are in a serious situation. If you see that the people that are in government, we have some that are involved in a cult, and then they are involved in some witchcraft, they are involved into some things that you cannot even imagine. The Bible tells you that spiritual wickedness is in high places.
That's right. Yes.
Perilous times. Perilous. It's perilous. When you are looking to teach your children that homosexuality is not wrong, and when we are telling them that you're born in this state and here to tell you that that's not scriptural, which means this is a lie. Perilous time. Perilous time. And the Bible went on to list them. Sometimes we overlook some of these things because it does not have a big banner over them. The Bible tells you about proud. Lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fear, despisers of those that are good. And I'm here to tell them we are seeing some of this evening in this
church.
Yes.
Traitors, heady, high-minded. The problem is evil coming, filtering into the church.
That's right.
Lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. Having a form of godliness.
Yes.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. I'm here to tell you that we are also some people that are under the banner of Christendom that are devils.
Yes.
Be careful.
Yes.
Be sober.
Yes.
Be vigilant.
Yes.
Your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, seeking about whom he is. The devil also is able to present himself as an angel of light, and even so is ministry.
Yes.
They look like us. They act like us and talk like us, but they are not of us.
Yeah. Oh God.
Be sober.
Preaching. Be sober.
Be sober. Yeah. The Bible starts off with the helmet of salvation.
Yeah.
Which means that this must be carefully processed. You must carefully think about it. You must carefully study and apply it to your life.
That's right.
Because this is the foundation where they are coming to distort the truth to get you swayed from the blessing of God.
That's right.
So this helmet of salvation is important.
That's right.
But if you are not sober, you end up taking life.
Yeah.
Watching a video where this evangelical bishop was forming alliance. He and some other Pentecostals. You have to be careful because sometimes when you hear the word Pentecostal,
yes,
it is really speaking to the New Testament.
Yes.
But the fact that you are, you, you filled with the Holy Ghost and you believe it and you practice it, you are Pentecostal. What makes us different is that we are apostolic. Also because we believe in the oneness of God and you should be baptized in Jesus' name.
Preaching.
So that we have to be careful to make the line of demarcation so we understand what people are saying. Not everybody that calls themselves apostolics are apostolics.
That's right.
Not all of them that say that they are Pentecostal are Pentecostal. Because you cannot be Pentecostal and not be apostolic.
Oh God.
Because the Holy Ghost will lead you into all truth. Not so.
That's right. That's right.
Be sober.
Yes.
1 Peter 5 verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, has a roaring lion walking about, seeking whom he may devour. In the relation to the devil, be sober. In relation to the forces of darkness, be sober.
Yes.
Why is it important today? Because the devil are invoking some spirits to blind the minds of them that don't believe. So you can't make somebody that's not a non-believer, a blind person, blind your life.
There you go.
The devil is seeking to come to the church. Yes. The devil is seeking to come to the church. He's looking all here. So he starts with those that are nominal churches, those that have a form of godliness, but they don't have the power of the Holy Ghost. You're not baptized in Jesus' name. You're not really a part of the church.
Hey!
Seeking audience, trying to look like us, but they are not of us. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. Wherefore, gird up your loins of your mind, be sober and hope to the end of the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. In your relation of your salvation, be sober. Be sober about your salvation. Because you are saved, you are called out, you are handpicked by the Spirit of God to be called out and to be separate. God picked you out of and say, I want you to be mine. Can you imagine the holy prestige, God? Can you imagine the God that created heaven and earth? Can you imagine the God that reigns supreme and in judge of all? Say, I want you.
My God.
There's nobody else is important as that. Can you imagine that? The greatest, most powerful monarchy don't make you feel that special.
Oh God.
For all of God's creation. All of God's creation. He chose us. He could have chosen a monkey.
That's right.
And did something greater.
Yes.
He could have created, he could have chosen some of the angels and made something greater. But God picked the dust and formed the man. But that it had no use and no purpose.
That's right.
What can you do with dust? You can't even plant trees with dust. Mm-hmm. You have to get some soil.
That's right.
Which is different from dust. Oh God, you are dust, which means you are just a nuisance. Just take up space, you just lock up the building and close all the windows, dust seeps in.
Yes.
Titus chapter 2 verse 12, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live sober. Righteously and godly,
yes,
in his present word, even in your everyday interaction, even in your relation to the word, the Bible says, live sober.
Yes.
Don't know good like everybody else. Don't know live any and any other. But be careful for live sober.
That's right.
You do not say to a dead man, live sober.
Mm.
The word is dead in sin. Mm. But you who are part of the church are alive. unto godliness.
That's right. The preaching.
So we who are in Christ, the Bible said, live sure.
My God.
Why is it so important? Because the world has lied to us. Amen. On many fronts and on many scales. Even some of the so-called war is a hoax. Yes. There are many things, if you were to dig deep, you will come into some trouble because you have discovered, you would have discovered that there is something that is wrong. Yes. The Bible says live sober. Yes. In relation to the leaders of the contract politics, be sober. Yes. What did he say? Don't believe everything you hear. Neither everything that you see. Amen. I listened to the interview of a famous movie star.
Yes.
This man is also said to be filled with devils and involved in an occult. When they asked him if he watched the news, the man said, no, I have a problem. If you believe what you see, you would have been deceived. Listen carefully. If you believe everything you hear, you will be deceived. And if you don't watch it, you are missing for. So we need the Holy Ghost to really help us to decipher truth.
Yeah.
We have spiritual wickedness. Spiritual wickedness in high places, not heavenly places.
That's right.
So you have some demons working for the leaders of the countries or some area. So you have some prince demon demons or some territorial demons that is controlling a whole lot of stuff. So when you think that it is just a scholarship, it could be a trap. Not against school or education. But be sober.
Yes.
Be sober. Yes. When you think it's a teacher looking out for your interest, it could be a trap. When you think it's a boss looking out to give you a promotion, it could be a trap.
Yes.
Because the devil is after the church.
Yes.
But the gates of the Bible tell you that the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church of the living God.
Yeah, premier.
Hallelujah.
1 Peter 1 verse 4. But the end of all things is at hand. Be therefore sober and watch unto prayer.
That's right.
The end of all things is imminent. It must happen. Something must come to an end.
Yes. Yes.
Bible said be sober. Be conscious. It doesn't matter age. I'm not speaking only to the adults, but also to the children. The very fact that God trusted you enough to put His Spirit inside of you, it means that you have a responsibility and you may held accountable to Him.
That's right.
Be sure. Be conscious that either the trumpet or the jacket, something will take you out, and the problem is we don't know when.
That's right.
The world is lost, and we are snobbish. Come to church and hear that. Be the church, we are snobbish. We believe we are better than everybody.
That's right.
And we don't preach and teach Jesus to save them. If we understand that the world is going to come to an end, if we understand that the next event on God's agenda is the rapture, if we believe that our mandate is to reach the world,
yes.
If we are sober-minded, it will affect our faith. It will affect our relations to our sisters and brothers, it will affect how we think. It will affect how we behave. Let me make this point before I forget. Sometimes when you are crossing threshold, let me put it into another, paraphrase it differently. Sometimes when we are moving to another level or another dimension, either individually or corporately, which is like a church or a group, when we cross a threshold, we encounter different demons.